I'm planning a long distance motorcycle ride soon, and I get a lot of questions on how to prepare the motorcycle for such rides. The primary concern here is to make sure the motorcycle is mechanically sound and reliable to take the endurance run. This video can also be a guide for inspecting and preparing your motorcycle for regular service. Before we begin with the inspection and preparation process, get the motorcycle thoroughly washed and cleaned up, which should make the later part easy. We will begin this with the tires. They should be inflated to the recommended pressure. The tires must be inspected for cuts and bulge and then measured for the tread depth. This must be followed by the rim inspection for any cracks and bends. While we are at the wheels, it's a good time to check both the front and rear brakes. Brakes must be checked for wear and tear and thickness of both brake pads and disc rotor. The brake fluid level must be checked and refilled if needed. Thoroughly inspect the braking system for any leaks. If you have any spongy or noisy brakes, then you will find a complete video in the description where different ways to deal with spongy and noisy brakes are discussed. Coming up from the brakes, we have the suspension system. A basic check should be done for busted oil seals, along with fork inspection for any deep scratches, cuts and bends. The rear suspension is usually robust, just make sure the jounce and rebound is fine and it's free from any kind of mud and dirt deposits. Next, we will discuss the critical electricals, where we will start with all the switches right from the primary starter switch to the engine kill switch. All the visible lights and their switches for indicators, headlights, brake switch and clutch engagement must be checked for proper function. The spark plug is again a critical part here, which needs to be opened and cleaned and adjusted for single electrode type. It's a good practice to change the spark plug once in every 10,000 kilometers. The battery is again something which should not be missed, especially if your motorcycle has a fuel injection system or it misses out on a kickstarter. The checklist for this should include check for voltage, voltage drop, water level check for a wet type lead acid battery, and also check if the alternator charging system is working fine. While you are working on the battery, make a quick check on the fuse box to check the standard as well as spare fuse which you might need in case of a blown fuse. Next comes your keys and lock set. It might sound silly to include them in this list, but it's a part of inspection to check all the lock sets, especially the ignition, handle lock and the one on the fuel cap. I know a few cases where riders have struggled with fuel caps due to lack of maintenance in the form of cleaning, rust removal and lubrication. Joining this checklist are two more tick boxes for the accelerator and clutch cable. Normally, nothing much can be done here apart from inspecting them at the mounting ends. Any kind of obstruction or resistance in pull or twist can be a sign to get these cables replaced. Nowadays, we get friction-free cables, so no need for any periodic lubrication. I personally practice a 20,000 change kilometers for these cables and prefer to carry a spare one at the time of long rides. They can also be routed next to the existing cables, which makes the installation really easy at the time of long rides. Chain and sprockets are something which cannot be missed here. Get them thoroughly cleaned from rust and deposits, followed by lubrication, and finally adjust the slack and alignment. If you are someone who is facing noise from chain and sprockets, then don't miss the chain noise and complete chain maintenance video, which also includes the chain guide replacement. I think we have discussed a lot of minor yet important points in this part. The next part will be a bit more significant, so let me know if you have liked this one so we can move ahead with the next one.